game, it goes without saying.
Yes, it does.
Others He's might not have said say. A little more. But if we sit back on a night that I think was surprising, like all the different ways we saw this game going, and maybe the rain played a role in this, this did not seem the way most people saw it. It's 1917, but what is the single biggest takeaway, Ryan?
That I saw a ton of 12 jerseys in New England, and there should have been more hoodies because Bill Belichick was at his absolute best last night. And all week we talk about what the buildup would be, who would kind of have the inside edge from the knowledge that these two men shared every Tuesday morning in their meeting. But I thought Bill Belichick was amazing. I thought J.C. Jackson did an amazing job on Mike Evans. I thought that they had a great rush and coverage combination, and they also fooled Tom Brady. They made Tom Brady guess or figure out what the defense was in his drop. And so for Bill Belichick to come with, to me, what we said all week was a roster that wasn't as good as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, was a team that would lose this game for sure. He gave this team an opportunity because of the way he game planned, because of the way he schemed, and the type of calls they made defensively.
Okay, and so, Rex, take us inside that. No one understands defense or Bill better than you do. What specifically did he do?
Well, it starts with the fact, knowing the fact that Tom Brady pre-snap will run tells. So if he'll run motion, shifts, all that to get tells of what you're in. All right? Most teams give you tells. Belichick gave you lies. And then in post-snap, that's when he got to what his picture was. So he presents a way different look and then changes it on you. And then he milks him down as the clock goes down. He gets back into the defense he wants to. Dan's going to talk about that later. And to me, that's what it was about. So was I surprised? I wasn't surprised. I know, look, you don't think he's going to bed with a pad. He's sleeping in bed. Okay, get up. I'm going to put this in. I'm going to put that in. And look, I'll be honest with you. I recognize some of those fronts.
To say what exactly?
No, I mean, come on.
We've seen some of that stuff.
Absolutely. And it's called a 3-2 bug front that we used to call it. And it gets you to count them 5-0 protections or whatever. That's the advanced class. I get it. But then it allows you to, I mean, so many different combinations in coverages and all that. Always change the picture.
Before Dan goes, though, I thought something that Bill Belichick said in the post-game press conference was telling. He said, nah, we saw Tom Brady every day. Yeah. You know, like so many times when you play Tom Brady, if you don't get to see it every day, you can walk onto the field enamored and understanding what type of thing you're facing. Bill Belichick wasn't.
It's not enough. Not enough. No. I mean, at the end of the day, that's why last night for me was fitting. Because Tom Brady, it was vintage Tom Brady. Vintage Tiger Woods, so to speak. Whatever it takes to win. You know, and that's the greatest situational football player ever was in those situations at his best. Second half comes out, leads a drive. 2-minute drill before the half, gets the field goal. And then at the end, when it matters the most on 3rd and 6 to get into field goal range, he gets the ball to AB. He drives the ball to Mike Evans. And maybe not the most impressive performance, but golly, an impressive win. You know, maybe not the prettiest game, but pretty enough. And that's Tom Brady is figuring out a way when all the chips are on the table and the emotions of all week. And I got to go back to a place that I was the greatest ever for 20 years. And I got to deal with weather and all leading up to it and finding a way to get a win. And that's why he's the greatest quarterback, the greatest player to ever play.
That's fair. But I've got people up here all week telling me he's going to throw 5 touchdowns and it's going to be a bloodbath. And maybe the rain had something to do with that. Maybe he was confused or fooled a little bit. And maybe even for a guy who has started 9 Super Bowls, it was a lot for him. In some ways, he looked early at least. Rattled is too strong a word. He looked uncomfortable in a way that he doesn't even typically in the biggest of games in Super Bowls. Did he look uncomfortable?
No, absolutely. But he needed time to figure it out.
Yeah.
He knew it was going to be a challenge. Maybe the rest of the country didn't, but I certainly knew it was going to be a challenge. Mm-hmm. And Brady knew it was. I mean, right from jump. And so, look, but can I say this?
Yes.
Did every single person in the world wanted to see Nick Folk make that kick?
Yeah, just to see
Brady come back with 50 seconds left, and let's see what he could have done. But to me, that's why disappointed in the game. No, I wasn't disappointed in the game. It went exactly how I thought it would.
So it leaves us, and we will have all morning long to dive into this and all the great action from yesterday. But I feel like it leaves us with 2 big questions. I'll start with you. Having seen what we've seen last night, the Patriots are 1-3. They've lost 3 home games. Yeah. Are they a playoff team this year?
No, they're not. They're not a playoff team. They're a team that can fight, right? They're a team that's going to contend. They're a team that's going to compete. But when you look at the AFC, they just aren't good enough.
You agree?
Yeah, I agree that they're not a playoff team right now. However, they're going to get better defensively when Stephon Gilmore comes back, and that defense is going to be legit.
Yeah, I think they're a playoff team still. I think that their offensive line can only get better. Trent Brown is going to get healthy. Mac Jones was fantastic last night. Stephon Gilmore coming back's a big deal. I'm not taking New England out of the picture. No.
And there was elements of last night that feel a little bit to me like a moral victory. I know we don't accept those here, but I said the same thing about Dallas after their first game. This team was there to the final kick last night. The flip side, are the Buccaneers a Super Bowl team?
As constructed, absolutely not. This team, with the type of injuries they have, with the roster that they're playing with right now, this team, to me, can't contend with the Cardinals, with the Rams, and even with the Dallas Cowboys when you get into a playoff situation.
Yeah, no, right now they're not a Super Bowl contender. However, when they get all their pieces back in the back end, then obviously I think they'll have a chance.
They got Tom Brady playing quarterback?
Yes, they do.
They're a Super Bowl contender.
But so everything about it. Tom Brady is peachy this morning.
Too bad he can't
play
they
did enough to win. Oh, Tom Brady. That's not the way it works.
We've seen it for 20 years.
But Tom Brady even said it's not 20 years of history. It's about now.
They were good enough to go on the road and win a game in terrible conditions against the greatest defensive mind ever. That their secondary is decimated with injury.
That's debatable.
You know who else was? Jameis Winston.
You're going to tell me they're
Jameis Winston too.
You're going to count him out? No. Okay.
No one's counting him out. There were a lot of weird things about that game last night. We have more on it as we go. Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.